Hey guys, it's Yuta. So here's another video you didn't know you needed. How toddlers speak Japanese. I was able to get some interesting footage, so I'm gonna share it with you. In this clip, a girl is trying a lemon for the first time.
超酸っぱいよ。超酸っぱいよ。いける？食べたい人。よし、じゃあここまでの意気込みがあるなら大丈夫だわ。じゃあ、むっちゃん、行きましょう。いただきます。
So, what do we see here? First of all, I can't understand everything she says. I don't understand this. And you can see that she can't form proper words. At the same time, she can understand a lot of things that her mom says.
ちょっとだけ食べてみようか。ね。
She said, which is a casual version of yes, and lots of adults say too. You can see that toddlers don't speak a lot of Japanese despite the fact that they've spent a couple of years totally immersing themselves in Japanese. So if you're struggling with Japanese, you can always tell yourself, oh, at least I speak more Japanese than Japanese toddlers. The key to happiness in life is low expectations.
食べたい人。よし。
So her mom said, 食べたい人, and she clearly understood. This is pretty basic Japanese. 食べたい is an inflection of a verb 食べる, to eat. In Japanese, we change verbs to express things like a desire. So if you change 食べる to 食べたい, it means I want to eat. 人 means person.So when you say 食べたい人, it's like saying, who wants to eat? Basic Japanese isn't that difficult. So if you want to learn Japanese with me, I will teach you the kind of Japanese the real life Japanese people today actually speak. So click the link in the description and subscribe.
じゃあむっちゃん行きましょう。いただきます。
She also understands いただきます, which we say before eating.And there are some words that she can kind of pronounce. I wouldn't have understood what she said had it not been for her parents. But her parents understood what she was trying to say, which is 一番, which means first, because she was the first to eat. Listen closely to what she said. Even though she can't pronounce each sound clearly, she can produce the pitch pattern quite accurately. 一番 has a low, high, low, low pitch pattern. And when she says 一番, she produces the pitch pattern perfectly. Japanese words have different pitch patterns, and sometimes based on the pitch pattern, the meaning changes. A good example is,箸, high, low, which means chopsticks. And 箸, low, high, which means bridge. So it seems like Japanese babies learn the pitch patterns first before they can fully pronounce consonants and vowels. I find that quite interesting. And these pitch patterns help us understand what toddlers are saying. Here's another example.
むんちゃん書いとこわかったわあ怖い、わお。
怖いね、目があったんだよね。
襲ってこないよあれ。
Here, it seems like she is trying to say 怖い, which means scary, as the parents have guessed. Again, she's not able to pronounce each sound clearly.But she can produce the correct pitch pattern. Kowai has a low, high, low pitch pattern. And even though she's actually not pronouncing it correctly at all, but she gets the pitch pattern right. She sounds kind of like kong. So it still has a low, high, low pitch pattern. Based on the context and her pronunciation, the parents could guess that she was trying to say 怖い, scary. Now, how about the writing system? Take a look at this.
これなんだっけ、これ?
お、よく知ってるね! 一緒に遊ぼうぜ!
一緒に遊ぶ? これは? お、そうねだね! これは?
ね!
お、よく知ってる!
ね!
どうした? ね目だね
じゃあさ、これわかる?
これわかる? リーだよ、リー
リーだよ
I think he's older than the girl, and as you can see, he can recognize many letters, but not everything, because Japanese toddlers don't know every letter. They only know the letters that they know. I remember being a first grader in elementary school. Not everybody knew all of the letters perfectly, so we learned them properly in school. So it took us a long time to learn the basic letters. If you are struggling with learning hiragana and katakana, now you know that it wasn't super easy for us either. Actually, adults can learn them faster than toddlers, so you can say, oh, I learned Japanese letters faster than babies. Remember guys, low expectations. Anyway, did you notice that he can't pronounce all of the sounds properly? For example, his se isn't very clear.
じゃあこれなんだっけこれ? お、よく知ってるね!
It should be せ Now take a look at this conversation.
何両編成?1、2、3で3両編成だね。3両編成。こっちは何両編成?何両編成だよ。数えてみて。1、2、3って。ガランガラン。1
She asked, 何両編成? And this is actually kind of advanced Japanese because these words are low frequency words. We don't use them very often. We use 両 to specifically count train cars. If you talk about the entire train, you have to use 本. So if you are counting trains coming to your platform, you say 1本, 2本. But if you are counting individual cars, you have to say 1両, 2両, 3両. So these counters are very specific. And we use 編成 to indicate how many cars that a train has. Do you remember the toy train has 3 cars? So you should say 三両編成 And that's what the mom was trying to teach.
1、2、3で3両編成だね
3両編成。こっちは何両編成?何両編成だよ
But the boy didn't quite understand. If he'd fully understood the question, he would have just answered 三両編成 But instead, he just repeated the question. So the mom gave him the correct answer and tried to teach him how this works. But when the mom asked the same question, the boy just repeated it again. The thing is, toddlers learn Japanese very slowly. Their parents don't teach them everything explicitly, so they have to pick up most of the things on their own, which takes time. But if I just tell you, 何両編成 means How many cars does this train have? Because 何 means what? And 両 is how you count train cars. And we use 編成 to indicate how many cars that a train has. So if a train only has one car, it's gonna be 1両編成. If it has 2 cars, it's gonna be 2両編成. And if it has 3 cars, it's gonna be 3両編成. And I'm pretty sure everybody understood. This means you can actually learn Japanese faster than Japanese toddlers. So if you want to learn Japanese faster than Japanese babies, I will teach you the kind of Japanese the real-life Japanese people today actually speak which can be different from the kind of Japanese that textbooks and apps teach you because they can be unnatural and outdated. So click the link and subscribe to my email group, Japanese with Yuta. Alright, see you guys soon. Ciao, ciao!